brought both sides a long way to reach this compromise.
It has been in limbo for years, perhaps decades, but now it appears that Iowa is close to having puppy mill legislation. Good evening, everyone. There is a bill that's aimed at cracking down on puppy mills. It's out of committee at the State House and headed for debate.
Emily Price explains the puppy mill problem and possible fix. It's tonight's top story.
Iowa's a relatively small state, but ranks third in the number of puppy mills. We're second in the number of puppies sold, more than 74,000 a year. And there's no state oversight of this booming industry.
In Iowa, there are some 100,000 puppies right now being bred to be sold. About half the breeders are licensed by the state, the other half by the USDA. And only the USDA has inspectors.
It's a big, cumbersome machine, the USDA, and it takes forever for them to respond.
Mary LaHaye with the group Iowa Voters for Companion Animals says in 2007, the USDA cited a whopping 59% of its Iowa breeders with violating the Animal Welfare Act. But she says the USDA can watch a bad puppy mill for years and nothing improves.
One breeder where 18 dogs were noted as having died at the facility, and all but two of them had been caused by cage fighting.
That's why she wants Iowa to hire its own inspector.
We're one of the few states that doesn't have state oversight.
We're looking, going after the bad actors and the unlicensed ones.
Representative Jim Lycum tried and failed for 2 years to get puppy mill legislation passed. Here's what he proposes this year. The bill would raise yearly fees for breeders to $175. Nonprofit groups like the Animal Rescue League would pay $75 a year. He says that would create $140,000 to pay for one state inspector and a car. That inspector could then fine licensed violators up to $500 and unlicensed violators up to $1,000 a day. Lycum says it is the first time breeders, animal rescue leagues, and puppy mill opponents have ever come close to a compromise.
It's been a long road, but I'm happy now.
In this bill, that state inspector would only go to a breeder if he or she receives a complaint, and the person complaining cannot remain anonymous. There would be just one inspector, by the way, for the whole entire state.
You mentioned that they have tried and failed for 2 years to get this going. Will there be enough votes this time around?
Representative Lycum believes he does have the 51 votes that he needs in the House, and he says there is some strong support in the Senate as well.
And one inspector for the entire state doesn't sound like a lot.
Yes, they do admit that this bill seems a little bit watered down, but they say it is a very good start.
Okay, thank you, Emily. Mm-hmm.